The entrance of the Word of God into our hearts generates light and it impacts understanding to the saints. This is Rhema Capsule. You will be tremendously blessed, enlightened, and empowered as you listen. Amen.
No, when we were created, with these eyes. I'm talking about. That's why if you look at Genesis chapter 2, the Bible told us in Genesis 2 concerning Adam and Eve. The Bible says, and they were both naked, the man and his wife, and were not ashamed. Do you know why they were not ashamed? They could not see it. The eyes they have is the eyes that sees God. The eyes they have is the eye that sees the glory of God. The eyes they had was the eyes that sees heaven, that sees heavenly vision. That eyes could not see that they were naked. That eyes did not see nakedness. It was an eye that saw glory. Can you imagine, saint of God, what it was like? The eyes did not see cancer. Today, the eyes people have is the one that see trouble, the one that see nightmare, the one that see lion coming, the one that see trouble coming. The eyes that we have is the eyes that sees evil. The Bible told us immediately in Genesis 3, as soon as their eyes were open, they saw they were naked. That was where the problem of humanity began from. Genesis 3:7. Was where the problem of the whole humanity began from. Genesis 3:7, he said, then the eyes of both of them were open and they knew they were naked. That was the Bible did not say that they saw, they didn't see, they knew it. That eyes introduced nakedness to them. That eyes introduced poverty to them. That was when we began to count numbers. We don't used to. The eyes we had before was the eyes that was reading our figures in the invincible. Where it is, you know, where our number is inestimable. But the eyes that was open was the eyes that got them to the knowledge of cancer. That was all cancer was in the garden, but because they didn't see it, it didn't affect them. You know, all these things people see in the world today troubling them, they were already in the garden, but because they did not see it, they were not troubled. It didn't bother them, it didn't disturb them. The problem began when they began, and that's the reason why your life will be determined by your exposure, what you see, what you know. My Father, let my eyes be opened back to glory. I put in a special request. The eyes I have in the beginning, I recover it. I recover my sight of glory. I recover my sight of glory. I recover my sight of glory. I recover my sight of power. I recover my sight that sees wealth. The eyes that sees glory is activated again. It's activated again. Is activated again. The eyes that sees beauty, the eyes that sees life, is activated again. Ilaboria masaba dagada, brikete gete, brigoria masaba kale, brabada, brikata bro preketoria, rika. My eyes are quickened to see the glory. I shut down the eyes that see nakedness. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Veils must go. You know, our eyes that was open to wickedness we must become blind to evil and we must begin to see in goodness. Your life secret is in what you see. What you see is what determines what you know. And what we know is what determines your peace or your pieces. I'm telling you, saint of God. So sometimes it's not the enemy. Sometimes it's not the devil. Sometimes it's you. It is what you see. It's what you know. It's what you are exposed to. It's God already settled it for you. You just need to come to the place of assessing it. But the access starts from your sighting. What do you see? And what are you seeing? That was what God did with Abraham. Saint of God. Abraham was always seeing what was wrong. Abraham told God in Genesis 15. Abraham saw nonsense and even wanted to sell the idea of his nonsense to God. In Genesis 15 verse 2, which is what most of us are doing. Oh Lord, look at my leg. Oh Lord, Lord. And God is telling you, I cannot see that leg. That leg you are seeing in deformity, you are seeing it from the eye corruption. This is why you instruct your eyes. You must see right. You must never see wrong. Many of us have made the wrong decisions because we are seeing wrong. Look at what Abraham did. In Genesis 15 verse 2, he said, but Abraham said, Lord God, what will you give me? Do you see I go childless? Seen. Can you see? Abraham was pointing God to his childlessness. God, see my childlessness. What kind of eye is that? That is the eye that is open to corruption. Please look at that scripture, Genesis 15. What Abraham saw was what he was using to pray. Oh God, my childless, when will you give me a child? And meanwhile, God had to tell Abraham and said, okay, Abraham, he brought him outside. In verse 5, he brought him outside. He brought him outside. You need to come out of that place where you are seeing wrong. Because your eyesight is what defines your life. What you see is what you respond. The reason why you are down is because of you are seeing hopeless. Change your sight. God brought him outside, everybody. And said, look now. Abraham, forget what you are seeing. Come, let me show you. Let me tell you something. If you can start seeing from God's perspective, your life is settled. He brought him outside and said, look now toward them and count the stars. If you are able to number them, and he says, so shall your descendant be. This is the vision I have for you. This is the kind of eyes I want you to have. See the eyes that sees what God is seeing. That is your eyes from today. That creature of the life of Simeon. Luke 2, 26. Hear what Simeon said. For good flow, the Bible says in Luke 2:25, before we go, say, Lord, my eyes is corrected to see the way you see, to see what you are seeing. My eyes are corrected. My eyes are updated. My eyes are upgraded to see what you are seeing. I shut my eyes down from seeing what my flesh is showing me, from seeing what the devil is showing me, from seeing what Satan is showing me. I set my eyes on what God is seeing. Is somebody saying that? I set my eyes on what God is seeing. Matuala pale, ayarusi kapoya. I use this moment of fasting and prayer to reset my eyes on what God is seeing. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Conclusively, as I release you, he said, behold, there was a man in Jerusalem, Luke 2:25, whose name was Simeon, and his name, and this man was just and devout, waiting for the consolation of Israel. What are you waiting for? It's good to be hopeful. Be hopeful. Stay hopeful. Miracles will happen in your life. I'm hopeful for miracles. It does not matter what is happening now. I'm hopeful for miracles. Esther was a slave. She ended up as a queen. Be hopeful. Something big will happen in your life. You have so many biblical examples. Follow them. Follow. Think like them. God will wrought miracles in your life. Miracles will happen in your life. Miracles will happen in your life. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel. What are you waiting for? Wait for glory. Wait for elevation. Wait to be victorious. Wait. Expect it. And do you know why? The Bible says in Luke 2:26, he said, and it had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit, he will not see death. It had been revealed, he will not see death. He will not see death because he will see Christ. You will not see death. From today, every one of you seeing death, I cancel that image. Every one of you seeing sickness, I cancel that image. Every one of you seeing poverty, I cancel that image. every one of you seeing your little, I cancel that image. I open your eyes to abundance. The Holy Spirit had to show him that he will not see death. Every vision of death, every image of death, every image of smallness, every image of inferiority, I cancel today. Rabatalia korebara, rebasata yapolia. Receive the sight that sees what God is saying. Enter into your miraculous today. In the name of Jesus. Izorodo dokosta ribarosha. Breketele gabra batabadoski tabala. Igerata labada. Every veil canceled. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. As you go to break your fast this afternoon, let your veils be torn apart. I declare veils deleted. Let your eyes in the front and the back, let them be activated. You begin to see visions. Angels are all around us. Why are we not seeing them? We are too used to seeing drama. No more. We start seeing heavenly vision. Angels ascending and descending. We start seeing transactions of the living creatures. We start seeing into the realms of glory in the name of Jesus. It is well with you. In Jesus' name I pray. Your breakfast is blessed to the glory of God the Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. I see you.
Rema Capsule is a product of Possibilities Fair, Prayer Mountain, based in the United Kingdom. For more information, contact us on +4479 0825-6098 through WhatsApp, Telegram, or direct calls. God bless you as you do. Amen.